topic of new religious developments in India. Of lesson number 20th, the national path to the divine. So next will be page number 192. So this is basically, it has been started from the 13th century. As we already has been getting the different kinds of ideas of the devotional paths in the Hinduism, where we had the northern parts of India and south part of India, different religious ideas, different the way the people they have been worshipped. So in the previous class we have this was been related to the Hinduism religion, like Tantris, Siddhas, Siddhacharas, Yogis, different kinds of methods they have been getting used, and at the same time this we have been here.
Mahabhagavatamu interview. Potana was called a Sahaja Kavi in
farmer family lives in the Warangal of our Warangal district of our state, and he wrote a famous script called Mahabhagavatam, and in spite of the natural feeling to the nature, it is been related to the common people. Now next poet is Talapakka Annamacharya from the year 1408 to 1503. This period of time was a popular singing composer of Andhra Pradesh, and he was as Peda Kavita Kutama. Annamaya dedicated his life to composing and singing the glories of Lord Venkateshwara of Tirupati. His compositions were mostly extempore in spoken dialect, and like the classical of the age, which was written in the classical Granthika style. In Annamacharya Chitramu, it is said that Annamaya composed 32,000 kirtanas all in Lord Venkateshwara. So what is this one more Annamacharya, the poet? He belongs to the Andhra Pradesh, our neighboring state, and he is the same poet plus same composer. He used to write the songs specially his way of his worshipping to the Lord Venkateshwara of Tirupati. And it is not like a classical grammar script, not to be very classical, people may not able to understand. In a common dialect, the dialect means the way of speaking, how we speak, in a common manner, so that the people can able to relate it and can able to understand it. So he wrote Annamacharya Chitramu, in which it is in consist of nearly 32,000 kirtanas on Lord Venkateshwara. In his kirtanas, he took up the subject such as morality, dharma and righteousness. He was one of the most few who opposed the social stigma towards the untouchable caste in his era. So what in this kirtanas of 32,000 of on Lord Venkateshwara Tirupati, what he wrote means that kirtanas relate with the morality, how the moral need to give it to the people first. Second thing, what is dharma, what is right, what you need to do it on, what you cannot do it on. About the dharma, second aspect. Third is right, which what is right, what you need to do it on, what you need not to do it on, in what way the people will be going to get benefit. So these three aspects we have covered, one is of morality, dharma and righteousness. And at the same time, we also get through all the social stigma about the untouchables and also about the women treatment. So in his kirtans, he said that in his kirtanas, Brahma Mukhati by Brahma Mukhati. And he described that the relationship between God and human beings is the same irrespective of the gender, color, caste, financial status. So in this one, he has been said in his kirtanas, irrespective of the way of worshipping to the God and the humans, the relationship between God and the human beings are of same, like without any discrimination, like color difference, caste difference, financial status different, it is nothing to be existed in the presence or in the eyes of the God. All are being the same irrespective of any differences. So what he has been saying is the universe is completely one, and the people who have been living in the universe is being also one in the eyes of the God. So there is no difference to be get done on the in all the people who have been living on the land. Now the third reformer, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from the year 1486 to 1534 was a Vaishnava saint and social reformer in Eastern India, present in Bangladesh and West Bengal. Chaitanya was a notable proponent of the Vaishnava school of Bhakti Yoga, meaning loving devotion to Krishna, God, based on the philosophy of the Bhagavata Purana and Bhagavad Gita. He propagated community singing of bhajans and dancing with devotion. He worshipped the forms of Krishna and popularized the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. So here this other poet, Mahaprabhu, from the year 1486 to 1534, this period of time, and he was a follower of Vaishnava. Vaishnava saint and social reformer of Eastern India. Eastern India is present day Bangladesh and present day West Bengal. So he was a very notable guy, belongs to the proponent of the Vaishnava school of the teacher. He has been bhakti and yoga, means his complete devotion to the Lord Krishna. His philosophy, the way of teaching, the way of worshipping, the way of devotion, he has been took from Bhagavad Gita Purana and chorus. Mahila chorus means the same person who will sing the song, means who will write and who will compose the song in Telugu language. So he had been as a devotee of the Lord Rama. He constructed a temple at Bhadrachalam as a, of Lord Rama, and in which he is popularly known as Ramadasu Kirtanalu. So he wrote the Kirtans for the praising of the Lord Rama, and he is consisting of nearly 108 poems. On that the book is called Dasarathi Shakuntalam, and it is completely devoted to Lord Rama. Now the other fifth poet is Tulsidas. Tulsidas conceived of God in the form of Rama. Tulsidas' composition, the Ramcharitmanas, is written in Awadhi, a language used in eastern Uttar Pradesh. It is important as an expression of his devotion and as a literary work. He was a contemporary of Shankaradeva of Assam of late 15th century, who emphasized on devotion to Vishnu and composed poems and plays in Assam. He began the practice of setting up Namghars, or the house of recitation and prayers, a practice that continued today. So other poet Tulsidas. Tulsidas being considered as one of the formation of the incarnation form of the Lord Rama. So he composed about the Lord Rama's in composition, so that is known as Ramcharitmanas. So that is wrote in the Awadhi language, the language in the earlier time it is being used in the Uttar Pradesh state. And it is in the first one that it is in literary work. So he was always contemporary. Contemporary means he will be used to have a one use of Tulsidas and another use of Shankara, who is resides in Assam state of nearly the late 15th century Eastern today. So he started Lord, according to this Shankara, he has been saying, if you worship the Lord Vishnu devotion and compose the poems, and he does the plays in the Assam. So according to this one, Shankara, Shankaradeva, Vishnu, worshipper of the Lord Vishnu. And here Tulsidas in the Uttar Pradesh, worshipper of the Lord Rama. So these persons, Tulsidas has set up Namghars, where is the place where they recite the religious aspects, at the same time they do the prayers, they do the practice, and till today also it is being continued. This tradition also included saints like Dabu Dalal, Ravi Das, and Mirabai. So as we following by these poets and these saints, so this new other kind of saints has been emerged. It's different places, different saints has been emerged. Who was this one? Dabu Dayal first, then next Ravi Das, and the female poets is Mirabai has also been emerged as the saintess. Mirabai was a Rajput princess married into a royal family of Mewar in the 16th century. Mirabai became a disciple of Ravi Das, a saint from a caste considered untouchable. She was devoted to Krishna and composed innumerable bhajans, expressed her intense devotion. Her songs are openly challenged the norms of the upper caste and became popular with their masses in Rajasthan and Gujarat. So Mirabai, as you all know, you have been getting to know the story of the Mirabai. She is a Rajput Rajasthan based princess. Mewar place that is in Rajasthan. She belongs to the royal family. She has been the princess of the kingdom. But she has been got married. She is a vessel. But she became the disciple of Ravi Das. Ravi Das, who he is a poet, belongs to the untouchable caste. You just imagine being the princess and became a disciple. The disciple means the follower of the person. So she became the disciple of Ravi Das. Ravi Das belongs to the untouchable caste. So when she became a complete devotee of the Lord Krishna, and she has been having an intense love towards the Lord Krishna. So due to that, she has been composed, wrote different kind, different innumerable bhajans to express her love towards the Lord Krishna. And in her bhajans, she has openly criticized the upper caste people by being able to have the differences. So this has become most of common in the Rajasthan place, at the same time in Gujarat state, along with the different kinds of people who have been existing to the neighboring parts of these places. A unique feature of most of the saints is that they work and compose in regional languages and should be sung. They became immensely popular and were handed down orally from one generation to the other generation. Usually, the poorest and the most experiences. Thus, the songs as we have them today are as much of creation of the saints as of generation of people who sang them. They have become a part of our living, our popular culture. So, all these persons, the poet and the poetesses, about Ripotana, Annamacharya, then next Mahaprachitanya Mahaprabhu, Kanchana Bhopana, then Tulsi Das, then next Ravi Das, Hira Rai, all these are the poet and the poetesses, saints, persons, Kapila, Guru Nanak, all these have been written, they work the way of love towards it, deities, towards their devotion, they work, all have been written in their regional languages. So due to that regional languages, the people can be have been connecting very easily, and at the same time, they have been getting to understand that what is the devotion, what how we can go for the worshiping of the place instead of going to the temples, no social differences. So in this way, composing of the regional languages, I think it's been passing oral literature, like in the form of orally from one generation to the other generations. In that also, by adding some, by especially from the woman, who is sing the stories about the deities in their regional languages only, or by doing the romanization, or by getting to know, but basically it was kind of completely in the form of the oral aspect. And these are the songs which we have been getting to know about this religious deity. It is not the new one, it is been from the 13th century, it is in the form of oral aspect from one generation to the other generation, it has been there, passed. And not only that one, from one generation to other generations, what are the experiences they have been faced, and that has been also been added as it has also been became popular in our present culture. If any religious aspect has been going this, maybe using the oral singing or oral praising, kirtanas going to the religious side. So in this way, this new kind of religious developments which has been took place, this is about not of one state, throughout the India, northern parts of India, like Rajasthan, Gujarat, the next Guru Nanak, the Punjab place, and the south part, this Andhra Pradesh, Telangana. So overall in the complete India, different kinds of poets and poetesses, religious saints, persons has been emerged, and they have been composed in their regional languages, and the people they have been adopted this form of this, the religious aspect in the different form, and this has been passed from one generation to the other generations. So in the next class, we'll be going to have a complete closer look about Bala. One still two more this new same persons, one is of the Kabilas and other is of the Baba Guru Nanak. And this Baba Guru Nanak, the new religion, the Sikhism has been came into existence. So these two same person aspect, we'll be going to discuss in the next class. Thank you.